This is a copyrighted work. Unauthorized copying or distribution is a crime punishable by up to 5 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.
Scholastic Audio presents Join the Club, Maggie Diaz by Nina Moreno. Read by Cyrina Fiallo. To Lucia, for being my hilarious sidekick and office buddy in a very tough year of virtual learning, way too many deadlines, and terrible Wi-Fi. Chapter 1. For the first time in my life, I can't wait to go back to school. My name is Maggie Diaz. I'm 12 years old and the middle child of my family. Not by choice, trust me. I have messy, wavy hair. And even though the shirt I'm wearing is due for laundry and I have a pimple on my face that's still deciding what it wants to be, I'm totally ready for 7th grade. Bring on the first day of class. I'm no longer a lowly 6th grader with no social media presence thanks to my strict mother, who makes me wear a clunky watch meant for toddlers. I can only text her on it. It's ridiculous, but my very Cuban mother got it for me after I started riding my bike to school so she can always track me through GPS. Even though I'm still stuck with the embarrassing accessory, Mommy says I can get an actual phone if my report card is good. And after my awful summer, I plan to make it spectacular. See, I'm even using vocabulary words now. List of reasons why Maggie Diaz had a terrible summer. 1. Friends were away and busy at camp. 2. Dad had to go out of state for a few months. Ugh, jobs. 3. Abuela moved in and became her roommate. Needless to say, I am desperate to get out of my crowded house and hang out with Julian and Zoey again. As soon as I get to school, I park my bike alongside the jumble of others and then race to where my best friends wait before first bell. Maggie! Zoey calls out with a big smile. She has her phone out playing music. Zoey is a flutist. She's currently on a straight A streak, is thinking about becoming a vegetarian, and has never said a curse word. Julian is standing behind her. He is an art geek, has new braces, and is the youngest brother with 4 older ones. He's also scared of the boba in boba tea. Julian's smile disappears once I get closer.
You're looking very sweaty today.
It's not even 9 a.m. and it's already like 100 degrees. Welcome to Miami. I had to ride my bike very fast or else miss telling you both the big news. I also super missed them. I high-five both of them. Zoey and Julian are next-door neighbors and have known each other longer, but the three of us became best friends during a group project in 4th grade. It was about ways to help bees. With Zoey's super smarts and great presentation skills, Julian's art and positivity, and my willingness to get close to bees, we crushed it. Zoey's face scrunches up. Is your big news that you forgot to take a shower? I sniff my shirt. I'm good. Drumroll, please, I ask, and Zoey taps rapidly against Julian's backpack. I'm getting a phone. Finally, Julian says, because I'm pretty sure I'm the last person in the history of 12-year-olds to not have one. Not having a phone means I'm practically invisible. No texts, funny videos, or games. No Maggie to be found anywhere. When do you get it? Zoey asks. She inherited her older but definitely still functional phone, thanks to her sister, who is much cooler than my sister, Caro. Caro is 16 and a walking makeup tutorial. Zoey's mom is Haitian-American and can be just as strict as mine over anything to do with the internet or pushing for too much independence too fast. We tread new ground with them carefully. As soon as we get our report cards, I tell them with a big grin. Their faces fall. I am not known for my grades. I'm more mature this year, I hurry to explain. We're 7th graders now. We're no longer the babies of the school. I plan on not only paying attention, but on raising my hand and participating, taking notes in a readable handwriting, and getting way better grades that will prove to my mom how responsible and capable I am now. And I'll get all the way out of my older sister's shadow. This year will be the year people at my school stop referring to me as Carolina's baby sister. they'll remember that my name is Maggie Diaz. It's going to be awesome. Who do y'all have for homeroom? Julian asks. Zoey and I grab our printed schedules. Mrs. Delgado, I say. I've got Jones, Zoey says. Hey, me too. Julian smiles, high-fiving Zoey. I try to hold on to my smile and New Year positivity despite the disappointment of not getting to be in homeroom with my best friends. But it's fine, because it won't be like summer when they were busy or off at camp. And I'll have a phone soon, so I won't be totally out of the loop anymore. It's probably way better this way, because I'll be so bored that I won't have any choice but to pay attention. After checking the updated maps that were mailed along with our schedules, we move with the rest of the crowd toward Third Hall. Unlike our elementary school, West Memorial Middle is huge. I'm pretty sure it's even bigger than the nearby high school. For some reason, they are always building new elementary schools, and there are a bunch of high schools, including the arts and STEM ones, but there are only like three middle schools. It makes no sense, because for 3 long years, a bunch of us are funneled here until we all get split up again. The bell rings, and even though I'm excited about our first day back, I'm disappointed I didn't get a chance to catch up on everything they did this summer. I've been so cut off. Tell me everything y'all did at camp in 30 seconds, I say quickly. Band camp was terrible, Zoey says. And I'm a little relieved that she didn't totally love it. It was so hot and disgustingly humid. Yeah, mine too, Julian agrees. It was at the lake, like right by the Everglades, and the mosquitoes were deadly, almost as bad as their so-called pizza. I'll just say, I have my doubts as to what they told us was pepperoni. Aw, I say, and try to keep the smile out of my voice. My friends weren't off having fun without me. We got these awful ham and cheese sandwiches that were dry, 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 Zoey says, then laughs. But then the drumline started a war, and all week we had to be careful or else get cheese slices thrown at us. That sounds disgusting, I say, just as Julian laughs too. We did that with the pepperoni. I don't have cool or funny stories from my summer. Food fights and lethal mosquitoes somehow sound more fun than being stuck at home with a cranky baby brother and sharing my bedroom with my abuela. Because, yes, you heard me right. I live with my abuela. Not just, like, live with her in the same house, which is totally normal. A lot of my friends live with their grandparents. But my abuela moved into my bedroom. You have a bunk bed, Maggie, my parents reasoned this summer. They decided that having another baby this year and making me a middle child at the age of 12 was a great idea. Never mind that my abuela snores all night. My parents are not reasonable people. The rest of the day is a blur of new classes and teachers, thankfully with no homework assigned. After school, I drop my backpack by the door and start to kick off my shoes. Pick that up, Mom calls out from somewhere in the kitchen before I even get my left sneaker off. How did she see me? I glare at my tattletale watch. How was your first day? Mom asks me while she clips coupons at the table. Lucas is strapped to her chest. My 6-month-old brother kicks his feet and starts to growl. Last year, I asked my parents for a dog, not a baby brother. Amazing, I say, and Mom cuts me a look of disbelief. I look at Mom. She's currently a college student with 1 semester left until graduation. She always wears her hair up in a bun, and I've learned the smoother the bun, the better the mood. And right now, the bun is a mess. I reel my smile in a bit. The day was okay. I had quesadillas for lunch. I picked desks that were in the front row so each of my teachers knows what's up. And I have classes with both Zoey and Julian. I didn't get to crack open any of my brand new notebooks yet or show off my new big brain outlook since it was only the boring first day get to know each other stuff. I only got to share my list of 5 fast facts about Maggie Diaz. 1. I have 2 best friends. 2. I am my family's official lizard catcher whenever one slips inside from our yard, which happens a lot because, hello, Miami. 3. The scars on my knuckles are from the time I tried to ride a skateboard, sitting down. 4. I hate strawberries but love raspberries. 5. I've never been on an airplane. The door opens and my sister strolls in, wearing sneakers and running clothes. She calls out hellos and then goes right to the water dispenser in the fridge. And how was your day? I ask her, but she rolls her eyes and points at an earbud before chugging a glass of water. My day was great, she announces when she's done, sounding breathless after downing all that water. Killed it across country, feeling good about my AP classes, and now I'm gonna take a shower. She drops a kiss on Lucas's head. Don't use all the hot water, I tell her. Why? She asks. Were you planning to actually wash your hair today? Instead of a kiss, I get a sharp flick. I scream and she takes off. I rush to run after her. No corren en la casa, Abuela shouts after us. Abuela's really nice, but she can also be really scary. Besides being my new roommate, she's a part-time bruja who always knows what we're up to. She's also a vitamin hoarder. Caro makes it to the bathroom before me and slams the door in my face with a victorious laugh. Carolina, please remember that she's 12 and you're 16. Mom calls to Caro from the kitchen, then looks at me. Will you two ever get along? Breathless, I point at the baby tied to her chest. Just remember, it was your idea to have another one. Lucas gurgles like an angry goose. Mom scowls at me, and when her eye twitches, I know exactly what she's about to ask me. Is your room clean? No matter the occasion, it's her go-to reply whenever we annoy her. Or she wants us out of her hair. I escape to my room, but it's no longer my sanctuary. Another vocab word from last year. Seventh grade is going to change everything for me. It just has to. Chapter 2.
Levántate, Magdalena. Vas a llegar tarde a la escuela.
I peek out from beneath my blanket. I am not going to be late for school because I set my new alarm clock. It's all the way across the room on my desk, so I have to get out of bed because I am responsible now. My abuela simply likes the bragging rights of being the first one to wake up every morning so she can call the rest of us lazy. I start to roll over, but the blank screen on my clock stops me. I am sure I set it, and it definitely had backup batteries. What happened to my alarm? I ask, bumping my head on the ceiling as I sit up. Abuela ignores me. She's staging a coup on my room. I throw myself out of the bed and down the ladder. In the hallway, I push past Caro to beat her to the bathroom this time.
It's my turn, Maggie!
Caro shouts as I shut the door on her. Not fair! Abuela doesn't sleep in her room. Fairness has no place within these walls. Wakado aggressively rattles a doorknob and Abuela shouts for both of us to stop yelling, I race through all the essentials, hair, teeth, and deodorant. I'm still not sure what to do about the pimple just yet. Back out in the hallway, my sister is fuming. Did you even brush your hair? I wince and wave a hand in front of my nose. You clearly haven't brushed your teeth. Nice mustache. Nice morning breath. Mom scoots past us. Lucas strapped to her chest in a bright yellow wrap.
Well, aren't we all having a great morning so far?
Caro and I do a little shoving dance for dominance before she pushes past me to get inside the bathroom. I follow Mom into the kitchen. She picks up her tiny cup of Cuban coffee and drinks it in one go.
Mom?
I lower my voice.
Abuela unplugged my alarm clock.
What?
My clock.
I say again, lowering my voice and looking at where Abuela is listening to the Spanish radio station while buttering slices of toasted Cuban bread.
She unplugged it, and I don't want to point fingers, but I think she might have stolen the batteries.
I doubt that, Mom says.
When will her room be ready?
The tiny house is out in the backyard and is currently just a skeleton of wood and concrete.
Soon. This is just temporary, Maggie.
This is just temporary is her latest go-to response for everything. But temporary or not, this is the worst. Mom searches the table and its mess of school handouts, homework, coupons, and junk mail.
Where is my phone? She mutters.
It's a perfect segue. I grandly gesture to the fridge, pointing out the sign I made. It says, Maggie's amazing report card, coming soon. Mom spares me a quick glance and a smirk.
Love your confidence, and I can't wait to see that placeholder replaced with the real thing.
That's how I feel about my watch.
I was thinking we could have a conversation about my bike riding privileges. Conversations are a very big deal in my family. Whenever there is a major change, we all sit down and talk it out. Like when Mom and Dad told us Lucas was coming or that Abuelo was really sick. I hated that conversation. Soon after, Abuela moved in with us. But it's time for another major change. A good one this time, because not only am I going to get a phone this year, I'm also going to convince my parents to let me ride my bike to Dolphin Park after school. Lots of kids from my school hang out there, and it's right by Julian and Zoey's neighborhood. My strict Cuban parents need to realize that I'm not a baby anymore.
Didn't we just have a conversation? Mom asks, distracted as she bounces a fussy Lucas and opens one of the letters.
Yes, about getting a phone. I need to be careful. If I ask for too much too quickly, this will all blow up in my face. Plus, a strand of Mom's hair just boinked out of her bun, so the warning signals are going off in my head. But Zoey reasoned that phone and bike privileges would go hand in hand, and she's very responsible. Dolphin Park is only like 5 blocks away. Zoey and Julian hang out there all the time.
Mom resumes her search.
5 blocks is pretty far away, Maggie.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.